any fixated ideas or preconceived notions. I speak in my capacity not only as a foreign minister of a pluralistic, predominantly Muslim nation of over 200 million people, but also as the representative of a society that
journalistic freedom in Canada, and I know it happens in the United States too, and frankly, you sure should be embarrassed to invite a censor like this, but back to the thug. Who the hell are you to censor me in Canada? Answer.
Now, I don't like...
I know you don't,
because you don't like free speech.
You don't like free speech.
Okay.
Would you like to answer that?
No, I just respond to you, sir. First of all, you want your sentiments to be respected. Just look at the tone and the tanner you've adopted. Is that the correct way? You have a right to ask questions.
Well, then why did you censor me?
Did I censor you?
You shut down my Twitter.
I did not.
Don't lie.
How am I responsible for that?
Because the government of Pakistan
is. Listen to me.
The government of Pakistan.
I've been respectful to you.
No, you are not. You censored me.
I did not censor you.
Don't lie.
All right.
Why would I lie?
Because that's what you do.
Okay.
No, we don't. I'm sorry.
Shame on you. You have double standards. Shame on you.
You forget. You
censorious thug.
You have double standards. And what you call freedom, at time, you are projecting certain sectoral agendas.
Minister, thank you very much indeed. One thing I would say, ladies and gentlemen, we can disagree on things, but we must keep our language clear.